हेलो, वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द सॉल्यूशंस फॉर गेट 2012 पेपर ईसीई ब्रांच। द टॉपिक वी आर डिस्कसिंग इज इलेक्ट्रॉन डिवाइसेस। कॉमन डाटा क्वेश्चंस वी आर डिस्कसिंग एंड द कॉमन डाटा गिवन इज फॉर द गिवन थ्री डायमेंशनल व्यू ऑफ सिलिकॉन एन चैनल मास ट्रांसिस्टर लैम्डा इज इक्वल टू 20 नैनोमीटर्स। Lambda is 20 nanometers. This is the part. The transistor is of width 1 micrometer. Transistor width 1 micrometer. The depletion width formed at every p-n junction is 10 nanometers. Relative permittivity of silicon and silicon dioxide are 11.7 and 3.9. And epsilon naught free space permittivity is 8.9 into 10 power minus 12 farad per meter. So for this given diagram, these are the information given, and you need to calculate source body junction capacitance is approximately A 2 femtofarad, B 7 femtofarad, C 2 picofarad, D 7 picofarad. The question is, the source body junction capacitance is approximately A 2 femtofarad, B 7 femtofarad, C 2 picofarad, D 7 picofarad. The correct answer for this one is B 7 femtofarad. We'll go with the internals of this one. The given information is lambda is given as lambda is nothing but overlapping area, overlapping distance where the gate and source as well as gate and drain are overlapped, which is not related to this question, okay. And depletion region width formed at every p-n junction is given as 10 nanometer. So this is what we are discussing. The given parameters as lambda, overlapping of gate and source regions. This is gate and it is source overlapping, and gate and drain region also the same thing. Lambda is given as 20 nanometers. W, width of transistor, that is also called as width of channel, which is 1 micrometer. This is next. Depletion width formed at every p-n junction is 10 nanometers. Depletion region always formed across p-n junction. So we will first examine where p-n junction is going to be formed, and once we are checking a p-n junction is going to be forming, we can see the depletion region, in which region it is going to be present. The given is n-channel MOS transistor. Always n-channel MOS transistors are fabricated in p-type substrate. So this is a p-type substrate. In this one, n-type channel is going to be formed. For n-MOS transistor, drain and source regions are of n-plus type. So this is source of n plus and drain is also of n plus type. So n plus source and n plus drain. So always this is n plus source and it is p type substrate, pn plus. That is, there is a pn junction formed, and here also drain is of n plus and p type substrate. So again a pn junction is going to be formed at drain side. So at source side and at drain side pn junctions are formed. And drain and source are going to be heavily doped regions, that's why it is N plus, whereas substrate is lightly doped P side. We know that one. Depletion width is more penetrated into lightly doped side, so that the total depletion width can be assumed as the depletion width is in P type substrate only. So here we are going to calculate source substrate capacitance. Source body capacitance are also considered as source substrate junction capacitance. So the other names for the substrate are substrate, body as well as bulk. These are the three names can be referred. So we are calculating about source body junction capacitance. So if you are checking it, this is source N plus region and it is substrate, that is also body P type. So p-n junction is forming across this portion, across this portion, across this portion. And if you are looking at three dimensional at the time, top as well as that is sorry front as well as back. It will be dumped into the NMOS transistor is dumped into p-type substrate. By that time front as well as back is also combined with p-type substrate. That we will see with some other diagram. So a p-n junction is going to be treated as parallel plate capacitor. P-type is acting as a conductor and n-type is also acting as a conductor. In between, depletion region act as dielectric. So that source body or source substrate capacitance is nothing but formula for the parallel plate capacitor, which is epsilon A by D. D is nothing but distance between the plates. The distance between the plates is nothing but width of depletion region, so that we are writing it as WD. WD is depletion width formed at every p-n junction. So D is replaced with WD. Epsilon is nothing but epsilon naught into epsilon silicon. Here we are not writing epsilon silicon dioxide, because the depletion region is formed in p-type substrate. P-type substrate is nothing but silicon. It is not silicon dioxide. So p-type and n-type are going to be silicon type, so that the depletion region is formed under silicon. So we are going to use relative permittivity of silicon, not silicon dioxide. Remember this one. Into area. That area we need to calculate. That area, you can think like this. Total area is nothing but area of four walls plus area of bottom. The four walls can be easily visualized like this. Assume this side is source. This is dumped into a p-type substrate. Whenever it is dumped into p-type substrate, think like in a bowl there is a water and you are dropping some peas. By that time that piece is covered except top. The piece is covered everywhere on all sides except top. It will be covered by the water. In the same way here, this is substrate, this is source, where 1, 2, 3, 4 are going to be 1 and 3 are going to be side areas, side walls, and 2 and 4 are going to be front and back walls, whereas 5 is nothing but bottom plate. The top side is going to be not covered by the substrate. So substrate is covering all 5 regions as indicated. 1, 2, 3, 4 are going to be walls, 1, 3 corresponding to side walls, 2 and 4 corresponding to front and back walls. 5th is nothing but bottom area. And we can see the dimensions of this one. Dimension of this one is 0.2 micrometers. Dimension of this one, that is width of transistor, is 1 micrometer. Okay. And it is height of source as well as drain region, it is given as 0.2 micrometers. And this is width of source region is 0.2 micrometers. All these are given in the diagram in the question. So now we are going to calculate area of four walls plus area of bottom plate. Area of four walls is nothing but first and third, if you are going to check at that time, second and fourth is nothing but both are identical, so that you are going to calculate only for one side, that is front side, and that will be multiplied by 2. So 2 times of front area is nothing but 0.2 multiplied by 0.2 plus these side walls are going to be identical with areas, so that it is 2 times of 0.2 into 1 micrometer. This area corresponding to side walls, this area corresponding to front and back. Total area is nothing but 0.08 plus 0.4, that is 0.48 micrometers. If you are going to check for the bottom area, bottom plate is nothing but again 0.2 into 1 micrometer. Bottom plate of one dimension is 0.2, the other dimension is 1 micrometer. So area of bottom plate is 0.2 micrometers. Total area is area of four walls plus area of bottom is 0.68 micrometers. Now the source body junction capacitance is epsilon naught into epsilon silicon into A by WD. Everything is known now, and if you are substituting the values given, the final answer you are going to get is 7 femtofarads. So the right answer for this one is B, 7 femtofarads. Source body junction capacitance is 7 femtofarads. Thank you.